Vikings 1 and 2 were the first U.S. spacecraft to successfully land on the surface of the planet Mars in 1976. They were carried by the Viking orbiters. The Viking landers were sent to two separate landing sites where they might find different terrain and different evidence. The core mission of the Viking program was to search for life on Mars. How do you test for life on another planet? The answer to this was essentially a laboratory inside a box. It could perform a set of biological experiments without having to return the samples to the Earth. The landers couldn't move, but they did have a sample collecting arm that could scoop up soil from the surface and then deliver it to the experimental package. Even though the Viking landers didn't find conclusive signs of life on the planet, they sent back over 4,000 images of the Martian surface, and the Viking orbiters sent back 52,000 images that planetary geologists could use to try and unlock the secrets of Mars's geological past. Planetary geologists were also able to use surface temperature data to reveal information not seen in the visible light spectrum. At the ribbon-cutting ceremony opening this museum to the public in 1976, the ribbon was cut by a Viking lander arm that was operated by a signal from Mars, sent by one of the Viking orbiters. Even after they stopped operating, the Viking landers and orbiters had an incredible impact on planetary science. It would be two decades before we would land anything else on Mars.